Hey guys, I feel like so shy because I haven't been here in a while. Welcome back to my channel. Did y'all miss me? I feel like every time I leave, I come back with a bomb ass look, you know, to say I'm sorry. Today I recreated this look by Stacy MUA 1015. I don't know if that's how she says it, if that's how she 1155, like I don't know, but she is this bomb ass makeup artist that lives here in Rhode Island too, and I just got really inspired and I decided to recreate her look for you guys. And yeah, if you guys want to see how I did this, be sure to keep on watching and don't forget to like and subscribe, because just because I was gone doesn't mean you guys can't subscribe. Like, I'm back, don't be like that. But yeah, let's get on to this video. All right, I know I look crazy, but we'll get there, I promise. So obviously I already started off by doing my eyebrows and priming my lids off camera. I also moisturized my face with this Kiehl's Ultra Facial Cream. Can you see it? Yes, there it is. Bomb, amazing. My skin right now, it's like post breakouts, like post breaking out, like it was just breaking out, but she's getting back together. And today I'm going to be doing this makeup look right here. I'll put the picture right here. Details, she says that she's using the Jaclyn Hill palette and the 3502 palette by Morphe. Since I don't have the 3502, I'm going to be using the 350 palette, which is the original one, and the 3502 is kind of like an add-on to this one, so I think I'll be fine. And I have the Jaclyn Hill palette right here, so let's get into it. So for her transition, it looks like she's using this color, so I'm going to use her. Her name is Creamsicle. Yep, I'm gonna be taking this shade on this Morphe brush. It was from an eye collection, so there's no numbers on it, but yeah, it's a Morphe brush. Okay, and I'm just gonna pop that right into my crease. She takes it pretty high up in her crease, so like above the crease, I should say. I'm gonna go like this, and I'm gonna put it on the outer part, but I'm not gonna drag it all the way in. I'm gonna put that right on my crease to create some depth or whatever. So now I'm gonna go back to that blending brush, the first one that I used with that transition shade, and I'm gonna go back and clean it up, because right now I'm looking like a hot mess. This Morphe brush, it was also from that same eye collection, so it doesn't have a number, but yeah, I'm gonna put the collection down below so if you guys want to buy it. But yes, I'm gonna use this like, it's more of a like definer brush, so yeah, I'm gonna take that color, this one again, and I'm gonna put it right like in the crease to deepen it. Yeah, I think it was this color that she used. She definitely used this color in there. Ooh, that added just some dimension beach. The same eyeshadow brush that I used with the transition shade, I'm just going back and blending out everything because I want it to look seamless and blended. And like, if your hand doesn't hurt at the end of this, you're not blending, you know, like, just gonna keep on blending. I'll go back with this, and I'm just gonna deepen her up. I feel like she has like a hint of brown in there, so I'm gonna take that same brush and take this brown right here, this like chocolatey brown. Actually, I'm gonna take a one from here because I feel like I haven't used this palette, so I'm gonna take this chocolatey brown, and I'm gonna use this to like warm this up a little more. I'm gonna put it right there at the edge, like middle portion. So now I'm gonna take this Morphe like flat brush and my ColourPop No Filter Concealer, and I'm gonna cut my crease. Just like shorty has it right there. And this brush is also from that Morphe collection, so. Now to clean up my cut crease, I'm gonna use this ColourPop E6 like eyeliner brush to clean up the cut crease so it looks more sharp and stuff. So what I do is I look down and like extend my eyelid so it's like tighter, now I'm gonna take this packer brush from Beach Cosmetics, and honestly it's so old that like it came off, but I think it's the 106 brush. It just, it looks like this bomb shade Rolling in Dough. I don't want to put that in the inner corner. It's more of like a beige color, but it'll do. Oh yeah, it'll freaking do. And now she used that blue shade, and I know what freaking color it was. It was this one right here, this bomb ass color. And look at this palette. My brother did that. Just in case you guys, if you guys thought that I was a dirty bitch, no. Okay, so I'm gonna pick that up on this Morphe brush that's also from that freaking collection. I guess you guys are gonna be tired of me saying that it's from that collection, but yeah, I'm just gonna pack this on. Okay, now I'm gonna go back with that shade that I used. Well, I really could have used that one too. I didn't have to go into that chocolate palette because literally they have the same shades right here. I just wanted to like gradiently go into the white. I'm gonna take this Morphe E36 brush. It's a pencil definer brush and it's like really fluffy so you could blend. So I'm gonna take this burgundy shade that I used before and redefine it in the crease because I feel like it got hidden. I'm gonna go back with that same blending brush from before that had the transition shade. I didn't put anything on it. I'm gonna go with this shade right here. Way too much on there, and I'm just gonna blend this out. I saw in one of her lives that she spritz her matte shades, even if they're matte, like, you know, sometimes people do that to shimmer so they could be more vibrant. She did it to mattes too, so let's see if that really does anything. Oh yeah, it did. Yeah, it made the color stay more. Let's do it again. Yeah, that really did help. I didn't know you could do that. So basically, even if it's a matte shadow and it's not, especially if it's one of like of a color like this, if you wanted to show up more pigmentedly, you could spritz it with some Fix Plus setting powder, whatever you, spray, coño, couldn't talk for a second. So yeah, I'm just going back with that same chocolatey color. I actually went in with this one again instead of the one that I used from this the Jaclyn Hill palette, and I'm just creating more depth and blending everything out. Finish the other eye off camera and I'll be right back. I'm gonna go ahead and start with my face. I'm gonna use this ColourPop Rose Quartz primer. Nice, there we go. Look at my hands, disgusting. And yeah, I'm just gonna use that to prime my face. I didn't even wet my sponge. I don't want to go downstairs. This is a lazy way to wet your sponge, okay? That's how it's gonna be. So I'm not going downstairs now. I'm gonna actually go back with this brush, like the you know which one I'm talking about. I'm actually gonna take the tiniest bit of this chocolate brown. I'm gonna add that right there to make it darker. Cause I feel like there was darkness, more darkness than hers. You know? Okay, now I'm really done with the eyes. To further prime my face, I'm gonna use this Urban Decay Optical Illusion Complexion Primer. It looks like this. She's bomb. She makes you really matte. So now that we are all primed and everything is soaked into our skin, I'm gonna go in with foundation. My favorite foundation at the moment is the Fenty Beauty Foundation. It's bomb. Why have I forgotten about these questions? From It's Denali, and it says, do you have a favorite eyeshadow palette? Honestly, I'm gonna show you. My two favorite eyeshadow palettes have to be by Morphe. I feel like Morphe has one of the best like eyeshadows. they have affordable eyeshadows and they're freaking bomb. Like, obviously the Jaclyn Hill palette is one of my favorites, and so is the 39A Dare to Create bomb ass palette. Like, look how pretty. So many colors to choose from. Yeah, I'm just gonna take my beauty blender and start. I like to put it with my fingers first so it can warm up to my skin. This does oxidize, and I feel like this shade is a little light for me since it is summer, and I got this like in the springtime, so I don't know. I feel like it looks good, but if I get any darker, it's not gonna look too good. But yeah, this foundation, you want to put it on in sections. Like, you don't want to put it all over your face because it dries, so you don't want to put it all over your face and start over here. When you get to the side, it's freaking dry and you can't move it. But yeah, this foundation is so bomb. It makes your skin look like skin. Like, it doesn't get cakey. I remember I wore this to prom, and when I got back, I didn't even need to touch up my skin. Like, she was there for me. She pulled fucking through. And you don't even need, like, too much. She's very full coverage. I mean, I feel like this is a medium to full coverage. Like, you could build it up. But I do feel like she has bomb coverage. The next question is from Monty Photography. And she asks, when did you start getting into makeup? I started getting into makeup freshman year. Like, I've always secretly loved makeup because all my cousins were always playing with makeup. I always used to sneak my aunt's mascara and try to take it off. She would always know I had it on. Like, nothing flew by. Like, she knew. Yeah, I just always had a love for makeup, but I actually started playing with it because I was doing fashion shows, and like, I did a pageant, and makeup is expensive, and booking people to do your makeup, super expensive, but very worth it. Don't get me wrong. Makeup is very expensive, and yeah, I just wanted to learn how to do it myself. So this was around like freshman year. So I started, I wanted to do my own makeup. I wanted to learn how to do my own makeup so I didn't have to like pay someone to do my makeup all the time, you know? Because every once in a while, it's good to get your makeup done by somebody else, you know, so you can take a break, you can take a chill pill. And yeah, different artists have different styles, and sometimes you want to look different. But yeah, I just wanted to learn how to do it myself. But that wasn't even the question, Alexa. That wasn't the question. So the question was, when did you start getting into makeup? I got into makeup like around freshman year, but basically my whole life. But yeah, freshman year, my whole life. Boom. Haven't even said it, and she's matte. She's cute. It's a little glowy, but that's because of my skin. So the next question is from Carolyn Perez. She asked me, what do I use on my eyebrows? I use the Anastasia Beverly Hills pomade in the shade Ebony. Bomb. The next question is from Moody Yori, and she asks, do you like your makeup or edges / hair more? That's really tricky. I feel like I like both. Like, my edges, I do them every day regardless if I wear makeup or not, so I guess. But I just like the way makeup makes me look. Like, it makes me look like a whole different bitch. I don't know. Oh my god, this is hard. I like them both, Gonya. I like them both. Yeah, because I'm not gonna stress myself out over this question. I use the ColourPop No Filter Concealer on my face, and it's in the shade Light 18. Next question is from Allison, and she asked, any tip for beginners? Tips that I would have for beginners is to start off small. Like, don't think that just because you want to start off in makeup that you have to go to Sephora and get the most expensive thing ever, because you have to learn how to use it first. So start off like small. Go to the drugstore, get you a little Maybelline foundation, get you a little eyeshadow palette, like from NYX. I don't know, like, very inexpensive stuff. Even makeup from the drugstore is expensive nowadays, so start off as small as you can, because you don't want to have all this expensive makeup and then maybe not want to do it anymore, and then you're like, what am I gonna do? So you know, start off small. And then gradually, as you learn more, you can buy more expensive makeup. Tú sabes, allá tú, that's your cuartos, you know? So I'm also taking this Laura Mercier to bake. And I like to bake right away because I have really folded under eyelids, so your girl creases really fast. What's your best concealer and foundation when covering acne scars? I really do like the ColourPop No Filter Concealer. It's only like $6, I think, and super full coverage, super freaking full coverage. Like, it's been compared to the Tarte Shape Tape, and honestly, I've never tried it, surprisingly. But it's really bomb, like really full coverage. And sometimes, like in the summertime, I just use it to spot conceal, and it's the best thing ever. So yeah, I would say ColourPop Shape Tape, ColourPop No Filter Concealer. And then for foundation, I would have to say this one that I'm wearing right now, the Fenty one, because it's really bomb, really light on the skin, and it's really full coverage as well. Like, you can build it as much as you need to. All right, so Maria Brito asks, where are you trying to go with makeup? Awesome skills, by the way. Thank you. I want to be successful in this makeup industry. I don't necessarily want to be a makeup artist, although I do like doing people's makeup. I don't see myself being a makeup artist in the future. Who knows, I might be. I wouldn't mind being a makeup artist, but that's like not what I see myself doing, you know? I'm gonna take this Anastasia Beverly Hills concert kit, and I'm gonna use the banana shade to actually, I'm not gonna do that yet because I just started baking. So I'm gonna take this BH Cosmetics 124 big ass brush, and I'm gonna use that to contour. I'm gonna use this middle shade. I don't see myself like being a makeup artist, but who knows, I might just be career to be makeup beauty driven, you know? So yeah, this question is also by Maria. She asks, what do you recommend for someone starting a makeup account on Insta? What I recommend is, again, start off slow with the makeup, unless you have a lot of makeup already and you're just new to the Instagram account, like the makeup Instagram account. Don't get don't believe everything you see on Instagram. Like, if you see all these companies trying to hit you up, you know, talking about, oh, the link in my bio or this and that, get featured, this and that, blah, 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 unless you click on it and it's a legit page with, like, you know. But like, I got scammed the other day by this lady on Instagram talking about she wanted to, I just know I got scammed. I might, if you guys want to know the story about how I got scammed on Instagram on my freaking beauty page, let me know, because I'm impressed. I lost like damn near $100 because this lady decided she wanted to scam me. Yeah, so just don't be naive. Yeah, don't believe everything you see on Instagram, but just have fun. Do it because you want to do it. Don't do it because you want to be famous, or, I mean, if you want to be famous, do it, whatever. Do it, like, just have a good motive to do it, you know what I'm saying? My favorite blush, the Milani one in the shade Luminosa. So I'm taking on that same brush because why not? I don't think I put too much, but too late. Okay, the next question is by the same girl. Shout out to you for giving all these questions. What is your favorite makeup look that I've done? Let me see. To be honest, I really like the rainbow look that I did. If you guys haven't seen it, I'll put the link below so you guys can see the video. That rainbow look that I did, I think, is the most iconic look I've ever done. Like, she's pretty iconic. I'm gonna go back into the contour palette, and I'm gonna use the banana shade and this BH Cosmetics 125 brush, and I'm just gonna press it in while like dusting the excess powder away. Am I freaking sweating? How do I have the AC on and I'm sweating? On this pencil brush that we used before, and I'm gonna put it there. Morphe pencil brush, but it's fluffy. And it's also from that collection that I was talking about. And I'm going to take the transition shade, and I'm going to use that to smoke it out and, like, blend it all out. So I just went off camera and popped on some lashes. These are Dodo lashes in the style D309. And if you guys want to purchase some, you guys can use my discount code, Glammed Up by Alexa, and it'll save you some money. So yeah. Alright, so I'm going to use another ColourPop spray to set my face. This is the amber one, and this is the one that actually sets your face. The other one that I used was a primer spray. So I'm going to use the Morphe X Bretman Rock Highlight Palette. I'm going to take the shade Mahu on a Morphe M501 highlighter brush, and go off on this. Look at her freaking beaming. Look at her. I like to use this brush because I can actually blend it out, like as if it was eyeshadow. I could blend out the edges because nobody wants a harsh highlight, you know. If you guys want to see how I laid these edges, I also have a video up on that, so you guys can check it out. I'll leave that also linked in my bio. I'm gonna use my Anastasia lip palette to make something. Let's see what this looks like. Oh, that's fucking dark. Using this shade right here, and I'm using it to outline my lips. My lips to eternity. Clean it up a little bit in there so we don't look cray cray. Next, I took this Milani lipstick in the shade Bahama Beige, and I just put it in the middle, and that's it. Okay, so this is the finished look. Hope you guys liked it. Yeah. Alright, so that's the end of this video. This is what I came up with. Shout out to Stacey for inspiring me to recreate her look. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys stay tuned and like and subscribe. See you guys in the next one.